So Apple has just released SwiftUI 4, but is it any good? And do I have a favorite feature? Yes and yes. Spoiler alert, it's not navigation stack. So let's see what's new in SwiftUI 4. Smash that like button and let's open up XCODE beta. Make sure you check out BeyondCode at rebeloper.com/community because we are closing our doors for the community in 2 days. So if you cannot see the join button right over here, then you missed out. So all you have to do is then just join the waiting list. BeyondCode is the developer, the community for not just iOS developers. We have a lot of types of people going in here. The most important part of our community is the events. As you can see, we are going to soon have a WWDC22 recap, and also you can take a look at the previous events also, because we always record our events. It's at rebeloper.com/community, and today we are going to talk about what's new in SwiftUI. So what I have done here is created a brand new XCODE 14 beta project, and I'm going to tell you my favorite part of SwiftUI 4. So what did SwiftUI 4 bring us? Well, it brought us a ton of new really, really cool features: shape style extensions, control size, charts, many more. You can see the image right over here. But today I'm going to highlight my most favorite one, and you will have to stay till the end so you know what that is. So let's jump right into our XCODE beta project. And yeah, basically this is how it all starts. It's a basic iOS project. And what I'm going to do is just remove the image and the text. I'm going to create a button. And yeah, while you're at it, make sure to go ahead inside the chat, try to guess what is this favorite feature that I'm going to show you. So here we have our button. The button here has a text, and it also has, of course, a private state variable is presented. Great. By default, it is going to be set to false, and then we are going to toggle it. Okay. So also, I'm going to create a new file right over here. New file, Swift file. And if you are typing inside the chat that, okay, this is going to be about navigation stack. No, it is not going to be about navigation stack. This is actually going to be much more than that. So let me just create a Swift UI view right over here. So a struct, detail view, and that will be of type view. And then let's add our body sum view. And right over here, I'm going to add another button. And this one will be a dismiss button. And right over here, I'm going to have the environment of dismiss. And I'm just going to call the dismiss on this detail view. Okay, let's come back right over here in the content view. And what I'm going to add right over here, let's have a little bit more room. We are going to add a sheet with the is presented. Okay, so let's just bind the is presented variable right over here. And the content will be our detail view. Okay, so let's see how this looks like. If I tap right over here, you can see that we have this really nice sheet popping up. And if we tap on dismiss, programmatically, we are also dismissing our detail view. But there's more. And that is our presentation detents. And let's just have our array right over here of maybe medium and dot large. Okay, let's just see how it looks right over here. Really, really great. So this is kind of the present half sheet, bottom sheet, whatever you want to call it. And if I swipe a little bit up, you see it's going to cover the whole screen. Well, basically nearly the whole screen, because this is actually a sheet. And if we tap on dismiss, of course, it's going to be dismissed. The same goes when we are in medium. Now, there is a lot more to this, because I can just also go for a height, let's say, of 200, and then I'm just going to tap, and we have 200. We can just dismiss. Tap me again, just slide all the way up, and that's it. Also, we can have, let's say, for instead of the large, we have a fraction, and let's just go 0.5, the 50% of it. And now if I just, let's just dismiss this first, tap me, and then the next one. Yeah, let's see. I think that we need to build and run again. Okay, let's just dismiss this. Just swipe all the way up. Let me just go there. Oh, it looks like, oh, of course, there are some bugs right over here. The fraction doesn't work. Let me just start and add only the fraction. Let's see if that is going to work, because the fraction should work really, really nicely. Let's just see that. And now, if I just go and tap me, oh, it, I think the simulator is kind of stuck there. Let's just build and run this on the actual simulator. Let's see how it looks like. I really want to see how the fraction works. Let's see, fraction, it's a CG float, that's fine, 0.5, okay. Let's move our simulator right over here. And let's see, let's just wait for this. There we go, tap me. 50%, really, really nice. Okay, and of course we can dismiss. Yeah, it's Xcode beta, so yeah, it will have all of these bugs, it's expected. But we can also have another thing right over here. So presentation drag indicator, we can set this to be hidden. And now we will not have this. Let's just go back here for medium and then dot large. And let's tap me. I think, yes, let's just reload our preview right over here. Tap me. And now you cannot see the drag indicator, which in some cases is what you actually want. Of course, we can just already dismiss that. So yes, the half sheet, bottom sheet, how would you call it, is one of my favorite new add-ons into SwiftUI. Now, as you can see, I have just used Xcode beta. And if you want to know what's new in Xcode beta, go ahead and check out this video right over here.